Golf is one of the fastest growing sports in the nation. In fact, more people now tune in to watch professional golf tournaments than any other sport on TV. The publicity is creating increased demand for golfing communities where people can live close to the course.
Golf course communities have grown in stature over the last 10 years as baby boomers have increased their leisure time. The environment is one of the foremost factors that we take into account when we develop communities. And we focus on environments where we can enhance the environment and make it a place where families love to live.
Recreation and nature often go hand in hand. Today's courses are being designed to embrace that concept, creating links where man and nature can coexist. High-profile golf pros like Greg Norman recognize that this type of development may actually enhance the game.
Well, you bring the environment back into it. You bring birds back in, you bring alligators back in, you bring the native feel back onto the golf course, right down to the edge of the fairways. So basically, you're just making the fairways meander through what was the original natural environment. And that's what it's all about. People like to walk through as much of a natural feel as they possibly can. Golf is a great walk in Mother Nature.
Early on, Greg Norman became involved with varied organizations in an effort to meet a range of industry needs. He oversees the board of the Environmental Institute for Golf, a division of the Golf Course Superintendents Association of America.
I never really had the intention early on in my golfing career to be an architect or be involved with golf course design. It was just it happened. And I got more and more involved with it, and I sunk my teeth into it, and I figured this was a very, very good future for me.
Norman's company, Greg Norman Golf Course Design, is designing and building golf courses all over the world with an environmentally friendly approach.
Our philosophy with the design is a couple of things. Treat each project like it's your project. Treat each project like it's your dollar going in. Build the best quality golf course for the least amount of money. And the other philosophy I have is the least disturbance approach. When I got involved early on, I wanted to make sure that environmentally wise, we weren't going to intrude on the environment. We were actually going to enhance the environment, recreate the environment, bring back the environment to the way it should be with the natural flora and fauna, with the natural feel of what's going on. So my least disturbance approach takes it that way because we don't go and move a lot of dirt. That way you're working with the environment and you're working with the developer because you're keeping the cost down, but you're also appeasing the environmental issues.
One of the things we like to do is do a thorough site assessment to make sure that sensitive areas on the property or high quality wildlife habitat is preserved. We also look at opportunities to restore or recreate habitat where the land has been degraded and provide connections or corridors so wildlife can move freely through the property.
And I've seen in certain projects that I've been to where Mother Nature has been taken completely away and it's a very artificial manufactured looking golf course. But when you do it with the environmental aspects and the environmental thought and bringing nature back into it, it brings people more to the golf course. It gets people out there, not just to play the game of golf, but to experience what it's all about. Golf is an experience in lots of ways. It's an experience of about challenging yourself on a golf course, but it's an experience that you're enjoying with the environment and with Mother Nature. So if you can amalgamate and integrate all that together, you've got what you're looking for.
We've protected marshlands, wetlands, trees, protected the water levels in the community. Golfers enjoy this community because it is a golf experience primarily where they play without residential or commercial interference.
And quite honestly, I think all golf course designers from now on forward should be a lot more sensitive to it. They shouldn't go and slash and burn and move millions of yards of dirt and push this and push that there and make it look artificial. They should try and blend it in so when the day the golf course is opened, the golf course looks like it's 20 years old. If you can do that, then you've done a good job of blending everything in.